Why do small businesses in Cameroon fail? Why do they shut down after only operating for a few years? Small businesses in Cameroon are faced with lots of challenges, and as a result, many tend to shut down. Many young people are very excited when starting up their own businesses, but only a few actually get to grow and sustain these businesses.
Personnellement, et selon mon expérience, il y a plein de réalités qui font en sorte que jeune entrepreneur ne puisse pas exceller dans son travail. Je dois d'abord noter la première difficulté qui est la difficulté financière. Pour un premier jeune qui vient de finir sa formation, il a besoin des ressources et puis ça se retrouve par la porte à côté. Le deuxième problème, c'est l'administration dans sa procédure fiscale qui n'est pas très accueillante. Il y a beaucoup d'argent qui s'envole dans la transaction entre l'entrepreneur, l'entreprise et l'État dans la démarche de paiement des impôts.
According to the General Enterprise Census carried out in 2016 by the National Institute of Statistics of Cameroon, there were about 209,482 enterprises and establishments operating in Cameroon at that period. This represents quite a huge increase compared to the previous 2009 statistics that identified only 93,969 economic units. The two main cities of the country, Douala and Yaoundé, account for 37% and 27% of these enterprises respectively. These cities, as a result of this, attract lots of job seekers from across the country. The business landscape in Cameroon is dominated by small businesses. That is 98.5% of enterprises in Cameroon. Medium and big companies represent 1.3% and 0.2% of enterprises respectively. The tertiary sector remains predominant and accounts for 84.2% of all companies and establishments surveyed, operating mainly in the retail sector. The secondary sector is in second place with 15.6% and is characterized by the preponderance of small businesses working mainly in the agri-food sector, bakery for example, and the clothing industry. Finally, the former primary sector with 0.2% of units remains very underdeveloped. A majority of the companies surveyed in 2016 had less than 6 years of operation. In terms of gender, 85% of the company proprietors are at the same time the main managers of their structure. In Cameroon, men create 6 out of 10 companies compared to 4 out of 10 for women. We are on a quest to uncover what causes the plight of small businesses in Cameroon. Why do they fail? According to the 2016 statistics from the National Institute of Statistics, economic operators cite taxation as the main obstacle they face, with 53.5% of opinions, followed by administrative formalities and tracasseries with 34.2%. Financing problems, that is access to credit, cost of financing, are also pointed out by 30.7% of the population. The same is true for the lack of opportunities, which stands at 18.1%, corruption, which stands at 18.1%, and insufficient energy and water that stand at 19.2%. In terms of taxation, the majority of companies, that is 78.4% of companies in Cameroon, are subject to the impôt libératoire. 12.8% of companies subject to the simplified regime, while 4.4% are subject to the real regime. For the first part of this documentary, we're a bit curious to find out how do taxes cause small businesses in the country to fail. We decided to meet up with this young lady who was once operating as a small business person in the Northwest region before relocating to the Center region as a result of the current crisis. She will tell us how the tax system in Cameroon discourages her as a business person.
My name is Marie Kwangara. I sell drinks, water, biscuits, chocolate, banana oil, tissues, fish. You can see the fish. I have just operated a store for 3 weeks and I was trying to tell them that I have just come. So I am trying to now get knowledge of what I'm supposed to do concerning the tax. So my neighbors, they were trying to tell me that I have to go to the council, I have to go with 10,000 francs, and like, but they did not want to even give me an ear. They knew that I have been operating and I was running away from paying my tax. So they said I have to give them 13,000 francs. So I pleaded with them that I've just operated the store just for 3 weeks. I'm an internally displaced person. I just came. And they did not want, so I was forced now to give them the 13,000 francs. So it was like they came and I was trying explaining it to them, but I don't know about it. And they were like trying to lock up my place. I have not paid the tax, what. So the tax system here is really difficult. It's really difficult. This one will come. I am the head of the quarter. I'm the head of this. He's looking for his own money. This one will come. This one. I strongly believe that it is the tax system of Cameroon that is causing the small firm business to come. You cannot be selling something, your capital is 5,000 francs and you are paying taxes for more than 5,000 francs. You must stop it. The business must fall. I cannot really say there is a big difference because it's the same thing. Yes, the only thing that I can say is that these people in town, you know, people in town are not the same like the people in the village. They are somehow advanced. Yes, they are somehow advanced in doing things like in the village. Even at midnight, they will come and knock. They will walk you up to buy, even at midnight. But whereas here, when you're closing time, when you give out your closing time, people are learned there. They will just know that this is your closing time. I am totally blank. When this one come, this one, I will just be hearing, or I will be begging. Because they used to come and meet me. Yeah, I don't know. I don't even understand French that much. If the government can really reduce, if it can really reduce the rate of tax to the small businesses, it will really be good and it will encourage them. So many people are afraid to go into business because they don't even know the risks involved in it and the advantages involved in it. There are people who are talented, they are gifted with this business gift, but they don't know how to go about it. But if you can really create forums, even schools, even though I know that there are schools, but not everybody is fortunate to go to school. But if you can create forum like you people, you are not in school. Yes, you have interviewed me today, you are not in school. Okay, see, we can pick forums like this that can educate people on business and even the tax rate. It will be good.
After listening to her, we decided to make a brief stop to meet up with a business consultant who has been dealing with the cases of small businesses for several years. We wanted to know what his experience has been dealing with small businesses and what he, as a consultant, identifies as the main reasons to why businesses fail in Cameroon.
Your question is very important, given that the economic fabric of Cameroon is constituted of a big chunk of young businesses or small and medium-sized businesses. I have had to do a great deal with them on the field, and they are doing quite well in terms of numbers. But in terms of success, they have huge challenges. I think your question is based on those challenges. Right, concerning the challenges, these businesses come up more or less as spontaneous businesses. So the lack of appropriate planning before starting the business leads most of them to business failure in the long or in the short term. Most often, businesses will wind up because they did not measure up their, income against appropriate expenditures. They get to get familiar or know most of the expenditures when, they are on the field.
After listening to the consultant, we thought why not visit the Ministry of Small and Medium-Sized Enterprises, the ministry charged with issues of small and medium-sized enterprises. We decided to visit the ministry at the heart of the Yaoundé central town.
La fiscalité est un point essentiel parce que l'entreprise qui est naissante a besoin de créer des emplois, a besoin de se pérenniser. Mais si, au contraire, on lui impose une taxation qui est importante, elle est vouée à mourir le lendemain.
From the interviews, we realized that the obstacles to small and medium-sized enterprise development may be environmental, financial, or managerial in nature.
L'entreprise, c'est comme un enfant qui naît et à qui on a l'obligation de nourrir, de vêtir, de donner une éducation adéquate. C'est ce qui se passe au niveau de l'entreprise. Vous avez l'obligation, vous, en tant que chef d'entreprise, de connaître toutes les lois qui concernent votre secteur d'activité.
The reflections of this four-part series documentary will focus not only on the external but on internal elements that may potentially have a negative impact on small and medium-sized enterprise development in Cameroon in particular and in sub-Saharan Africa as a whole.